What's up, everyone? This is Jeff from Sorta Healthy, and today I'm here to talk about the Online Trainer Academy. Now, as you may know, the bulk of our business is in-person training at our studio, but with the changing tides, we've been spending some more of our time with online training as well. The Personal Trainer Development Center's online trainer certification costs $799 if you go with their cheaper option. For a training certification, that's a pretty decent-sized investment. Our goal for today is to review this certification and see where it falls on our personal trainer education tier list. We'll tackle that soon. Let me preface this video by saying that you don't need an online training certification to do online training. Really, you don't need any certifications, but you should probably have a personal training certification before trying to write and sell anyone programming or nutrition. Before we start to break this course down, all I ask is that you consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so already. This is the best way to support this channel, which is a free resource to all fitness professionals. Thank you very much for the continued support, everyone. I really appreciate it. Now let's jump right into the Online Trainer Academy, or the OTA, as it's commonly called. Jon Goodman is the creator and face of the OTA. If you've studied anything about online training, you've definitely seen his name, as he's one of the primary coaches in this domain. He also wrote that personal training book, Ignite the Fire, which I think is pretty good. I've seen a good amount of reviews on the OTA, and I think it's fair to say that those reviews are mixed. Reviews of this certification range from it being 0% helpful in learning to start and run an online business. I've actually even seen some people refer to Jon Goodman as a snake oil salesman, and then I've seen other people online claim it's the most helpful certification out there. I'm so-so on many different personal trainer certifications, but I do think there's always little bits of wisdom to take away from pretty much any of them. Reviews aside, we decided to take this course for a few reasons. One, we're working on building and growing our online business and thought having some specific steps and direction would be helpful. Two, we wanted to get the insider scoop on what this program was really like. And three, we figured it would make good content for you guys at the very least. We have a job to do after all, and that involves informing and helping all of you. Like I said before, we've spent a lot of time building our in-person training business, and so far it's gone really well. So well, in fact, that it doesn't leave a ton of time for much else. While we've done some online training and nutrition over the last few years, it hasn't been a primary focus. That's changing though, and we're focusing more on building our online coaching business over the next few years. The problem is that sometimes you know what you need to do, you just don't know the best way to get there. I think you all know exactly what I mean, and here's where I get a little bit vulnerable with you guys. Being that online training is a lot different than our in-person training, we've struggled a bit at identifying our ideal online client and really speaking to them consistently. We thought this program might be a good way for us to really refine some things that weren't working for us online. And by us, I mean mostly Alexis. Although I want to participate in online training too, my wife is making it a bigger focus for herself. I'm just kind of her content creator sidekick or something like that. But anyways, now that we've gotten some of that background stuff out of the way, let's get into the important stuff, and of course, that includes talking about the course itself. There are a couple options for the course when signing up. One is just the course itself, and the other includes a mentor to work with you as you go through the coursework. We didn't opt for a mentor, so honestly, I can't report on whether or not that's helpful, although I can assume it would be. Once you sign up, you log into the OTA dashboard and request to join the student and grad Facebook group. All of the coursework materials are in your dashboard. Lessons, downloads, the digital textbook, and the exam are all there. Modules unlock as you complete lessons, so you can't skip around the website lessons as you could in a book. The majority of the online lessons are some text with a video of Jon Goodman going over the topic and essentially what you would find in the textbook. In most lessons, there are little prompts and boxes for you to apply what you just learned and save it within the lesson. This is a super helpful aspect of the course lessons because it encourages you to apply what you learned right now instead of 6 months from now when you're feeling motivated. There are four main modules that you need to go through to unlock the test, and then a bonus one with some added material. Each module concludes with a simple 5-question quiz. One of the best things about the course is the amount of free stuff included. I say free in quotes because we already talked about the price tag of the course, and that's something we'll be coming back to later in this video as well. That being said, there are downloads for just about everything, and you can use those, replicate them, or make Google Doc copies of them, and that saves tons of time and energy. There's also lots of suggestions for software, setting things up, and tips and tricks for actual application. While all of this stuff can be incredibly helpful, just like anything else, it's all about how you actually use it. Your business will not change just because you downloaded a new form or signed up for an account on Trainerize. That being said, if you do utilize the materials, you could easily restructure, add to, or start your business and be in a really good place. What do the modules actually teach you? Well, they teach you all about being an online trainer. They go over things like how to set up your business, structure it, choose your niche, use your words effectively, set up your programs, price yourself, etc. Both myself and Alexis went through the information and we found found it to be pretty practical. There was minimal BS, and there were no promised shortcuts or anything a random Instagram business guru would try and get you to do. Essentially, it's like, here, this is how it works. Follow these steps, put some effort in, and be rewarded. Pretty simple to think about, and from what I can tell, really not that difficult to actually put into practice. Work hard, build your business. Don't work hard, don't expect to grow your business. A downside to this course that people are likely to point out is that you can find all this information online for free if you're looking for it. Of course, that would also be true for literally any other certification that does exist. Plenty of other people have put out info on how to get clients, set up your business, run a website, etc. The OTA really just attempts to put it all together for you. Most of Jon's social media advice is focused around Facebook, but a lot of it would certainly work for Instagram as well. One aspect that's talked about directly, but also indirectly, is confidence. Essentially, you need to build up your confidence in all areas to be a successful online coach. No confidence equals no clients. Lots of confidence equals possibility of lots of clients. In addition to the modules and textbook, you always have the Facebook group to ask questions in too. We were mostly lurkers in the group, but we did see lots of good questions asked. Sometimes Jon himself would answer these questions, but whether it was him or one of the other mentors responding, it seemed to be a pretty good community. If you're a person that needs to ask questions for understanding or likes to read other people's questions, this group would prove to be a highly valuable aspect of the course. Let's get to the important part of the course. The test. Just kidding, it's really not that important if you paid attention. When you complete that last module, you can unlock the final test, which is 60 questions with a 1 hour time limit. Even if you're a slower test taker, you shouldn't worry about finishing. Most of the questions are fairly self-explanatory. I would even say easy if you paid attention. Since the test is done in a browser window, you can also use notes or your textbook if you want to. To pass, you only need 45 out of 60 questions right. So if you took the course seriously up until this point and studied the material, you should have no issues passing. Unlike a standard certification exam, there's no science to memorize or progression protocols, mainly just vocab, procedure, and best practices. The final exam is set up exactly like the module quizzes, including some of the same questions. If you pass those, you should be good. If you don't pass the test, you can take it again for $50. But honestly, you can take it open book, so you really shouldn't have to do that. Once you pass, you're emailed info on how to get your certificate. Hint, it's with everything else in your portal. They suggest posting that you passed all over the place. To each their own on that one. Once you've passed, well, now what do you do? Really, just implement or continue to implement the things that you learned consistently. There are lots of opportunities to improve and modify your coaching as you need to. What you're probably thinking now is this course for me or is it worth it? Honestly, unless you're already absolutely killing it as an online coach, this course could be beneficial to you. I would say it's good for someone who's trying to get started but doesn't know what to do, is working on growing but really isn't getting anywhere. It's good for someone who's overwhelmed by all the ins and outs of online training. It's also good for someone who has a couple clients but is kind of stuck there, as well as someone who can get clients but they don't stick around, or maybe those clients aren't consistent or aren't getting good results. It's also good for someone trying to build their social media following, or someone that just needs to refine their systems. If you already have a large following or client base, are able to hold on to and get new clients easily, have clients getting great results, have a system that is working well for you and your clients, or simply aren't willing to put in any effort, then the Online Trainer Academy probably wouldn't be worth your hard-earned dollar. And since we brought up your money, that price is kind of high. And although the course can help you feel more confident training people online, it's not like the course gives you credentials that you really need to get into online training. With some hard work and maybe some luck, you can get it done on your own. What's hard about some of these online courses like this one is that a lot of the information included does just seem like common sense, which I would say that's true. But having a set of steps and procedures helps you to utilize that common sense in a way that actually works. Anyways, for us, a lot of the information in the OTA wasn't new or incredibly revolutionary. It was just written and formatted in a way that encouraged action versus passive consumption. There was some, I thought I was doing that, but I'm not, kind of deals too, and also just some things that we hadn't thought about putting into action. While online training is not our primary priority right this second, it definitely could be at some point in the future, so I think it's important to get involved on some level. I think it's smart to diversify your income streams as a trainer if possible, given the uncertainty of the job. Having some online training clients could certainly be helpful for that. Within the next few years, we'd love to be able to greatly increase our income with online coaching and reduce our in-studio hours by a lot to accommodate that. Online training allows you to reach so many more people than in-person training and really expand your reach as a trainer. That being said, we started implementing things from the course into our social media and training businesses right away and have already seen some positive changes. Just like anything, remember that you don't have to do every single solitary thing in the course to see changes. Pick and choose the things that make the most sense to you and your business. Okay then, so moment of truth. Where does it fall on our tier list? We're giving the OTA a B. It's not necessary, but it definitely could help you in the long run, which is probably true of just about any solid certification. Besides not needing it to advance your career, the price tag is really what hinders it from getting a higher score. Although of course you could make that investment back with just a couple of online clients. We plan on doing a video in a few months that will go over how much progress we've made in growing our online business. We'll be utilizing many of the available resources provided by the OTA to help with that. Scores are not static on this tier list, and we may alter this grade slightly in the future based on our results. So stay tuned for that. Have you thought about moving into online training? Or are you already doing some? Have you ever considered completing a course to grow your online business? Make sure to let us know down in the comments below. And if you've already taken a course on online training, please share your thoughts on the course down in the comments as well. That's all that we have for today, everyone. If you found the video helpful, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel, because that does help the channel to grow, which does allow me to create more free content for all of you. Thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time, stay sort of healthy.